Bukedia District went to the polls on June 14th after the LC5 seat fell vacant following the death of the former chairperson, Moses Olemkan, who succumbed to colon cancer in December 2022.
I, Sulaiman Kato, declare that Oita Sam Odeke is a duly nominated candidate to contest for election as district chairperson, Bukedia District.
The by-election, which showed six contestants battling for the seat, was won by NRM candidate Mary Akol after chaotic scenes.
They've taken my fingerprint, I've asked for the ballot paper, they've told me the ballots are over.
Ahead of the election, David Stephen Omagor, an independent candidate, was attacked as he approached the Electoral Commission offices for nomination, and he was badly beaten. In the process, his clothes were torn, whereas the same group made off with his nomination papers.
How could you allow the boxes to be full at this time? The voting time is at 8. The boxes at 7, now they are full.
On July 6, 2023, in the Oyam North County by-election, the situation was likely the same, as voters went into the polls after the Oyam North County seat fell vacant following the murder of the former MP and Labour and State Minister retired Colonel Charles Okello Engola. The by-election attracted four candidates, namely UPC's Dr. Eunice Apio Otuko, FDC's Freddie Newton Okello, NOPE's Daniel Okello, and Engola's son, Samuel Okello.
That's why yesterday we took the greater part of the day to just relax, train our agents and relax. So it's been wonderful. But as it continued now drizzling, people kept on braving the drizzle.
Apio was declared winner by Oyam District Returning Officer in an election which he said ended in chaos.
The sub-county chairperson was arrested. He's called Robert Walawele. He's a long-serving chairperson of the Uganda People's Congress Party in this sub-county. On his way to fueling his motorbike, just by the sub-county headquarters, by a gang of soldiers led by, I'm told, an RDC from another district.
At one global polling station in Otwal sub-county, there was ruckus and bitter exchange of words between UPC's party president, Jimmy James Michael Akena, and NRM Electoral Commission chairperson, Dr. Tang Odoi, when a group of people attacked the polling station and voted NRM candidate Junior Engola.
If you want proof, let's open that box.
Open that box
and see the votes inside.
Him.
Open that box. You see the 250 votes which are taken. They are above the law.
Excuse me.
Sideway.
The political party I lead condemned this exercise. We condemn it again.
Check that box.
Right now, he is not above the law.
The scuffle came shortly after the arrest of 17 UPC leaders and the party members over election bribery before they were released on bond after spending a night in the cell. Jimmy James Michael Akena accused NRM's Tang Odoi of openly rigging the election, an allegation Tang Odoi vehemently denied.
Zero, you are rigging, you are stealing a vote.
That is unfair.
You can't win or you steal.
Out of sorts, while they continue to steal. There are some stations where people might have been cowed that they have not been able to bring it up. And the teams who are moving around making sure are also now at jeopardy. One of my leaders has just, maybe while I was here, got arrested. And so it's just theft.
But I think we have now clandestine activities even within opposition to start to disrupt elections where they are losing. And this is one research we are going to do. Because you can't tell me that our goons disrupted a polling station. We've not had any aspect to deal with ballot stuffing.
Tony Ochen Okello, the LC5 councillor of Icheme sub-county, says UPC was very organized despite the intimidation, a reason they won the by-election.
Because we have got the chairperson of the sub-county and Egiso, they are disorganizing the votes. And I think the president was very serious on this, what happened in Kenya.
Justice Simon Biabakama, the Electoral Commission chairperson, while in Oyam last week, reiterated a call for free and fair elections.
A joint process where every stakeholder plays their role in a manner that is in accordance with the law.
Leaders have condemned the attack, intimidation, and the violence mad in the by-elections. Accusing party leaders of masterminding violence, they have further demanded intervention from the president. According to a letter dated June 26, 2023, signed by President Museveni and addressed to Brigadier Geno Isoke, the president claimed that he had learnt there were several cases of indiscipline in the Bukedia by-election which should be investigated. The president also noted that although NRM won with 91% and with an 87% voter turnout, the incidents on the nomination eve and on the actual day of voting should be investigated. Report compiled by Solomon Okabo for the news.